Once in a while, I get asked about how I render my thumbnails, so this is a quick video. Do stay tuned to the end, where I give a bonus tip on how to achieve a 3D printed look. Do note that much of what I know is through experimentation, so some of these workflows might not be the best. So let's go to the render workspace. The first thing to do is to assign an appearance or a material to the model. Expand the library and choose a material to your liking. I usually use plastic with a matte finish or with some texture. Let's go ahead and choose a plastic with texture. I will simply drag this into the model. In the Apply Tool settings, Body/Components is the current option, so the appearance has been applied to the whole solid. The appearance that has been applied appears here in this box. Let's try to change the color. I usually want to keep the original color on hand, just in case I need to return to it. So let's right-click and duplicate. Double-click on the duplicate to bring up the color swatch. From here, you can change the color. Once again, drag this in. To be able to see the color dynamically change in a viewing window, double-click on the active appearance and change the color accordingly. For appearances with texture, you can adjust the scale of the texture. If you want to apply a color to individual faces, activate the Faces option and drag the desired appearance onto that face. I generally try to achieve some level of photorealism in my thumbnails. For that, the most crucial factor is lighting. Which brings us to Scene Settings. Go to the Environments library to select an environment. For most of my thumbnails, I use Sharp Highlights or Photo Booth. Just double-click on the environment to select. Let's go to Settings. For most appearances, you can leave the brightness at the default level. For some appearances, the default level of brightness will result in overexposure, so you might need to tone that down a little. We can adjust the position of the light source by clicking on this icon here and adjusting the slider. For me, I will try to adjust this to accentuate the honeycomb pattern and the texturing. Another element that adds to the photorealism is the shadows. Make sure the ground plane is checked. The shadows are obviously affected by the position of the light source. When you are done with the setup, you can use the In Canvas Render option to get a quick preview. This renders a model within the viewing window. At this point, I'm ready to perform the actual render. Adjust the image size. And choose whether you want to do a cloud or a local render. To get the best image quality, I will click on Advanced Settings and adjust the render quality. The higher the quality, the more time it takes to render. Once you start the render process, a thumbnail appears in the gallery. Once the render is complete, you can save this out as an image. A few more quick tips here. Wherever possible, add fillets to round off edges. Sharp edges when rendered tend to look very flat. Another thing that adds to the realism is depth of view. Under scene settings, check on the depth of view option. Click on the select box for center of focus and choose where the camera focuses on. Adjust this slider to control the amount of blurring. Without closing the scene settings window, let's perform an in-canvas render. We can see that the focus is here on the near side, while the far side has been blurred. With the center of focus select box active, let's change the focus to the far side. The in-canvas render automatically updates itself, so the far side is now in focus, while the near side is blurred. In my experience rendering with the different materials, I've gotten very good results with wood. If you want to render an object on a table, you can simply model a flat plate and assign a wood appearance to that plate. Do take note that wood often requires a much longer render time compared to the other materials. So for the bonus tip, I will explain how we can achieve a 3D printed look where you can actually see the print layers. In this case, what you see here are the actual paths traversed by the print head. I will demonstrate this with a simple cube. Export this as a 3MF file. I'm going to open this 3MF file in a slicer program by Prusa. I'm not sure if other slicers can do this or indeed the slicer within Fusion. Do let me know in the comments. Once you import the file into the slicer, put it into position and slice it as you would when you prepare a 3D print. Once done, go to export and export two paths as an OBJ file. Go back into Fusion and open this OBJ file. In this case, you can even see the skirt of the 3D print. From here, you will go through the same steps of assigning appearances and adjusting the lighting to produce a render.